I used to be a firm believer in the principle of, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Because when it came to studying throughout high school and college, I got pretty good grades, so I thought I was doing something right. But when I got to medical school, I started to struggle with the overwhelming amount of information to learn. And my grades started slipping, even though I was working a lot harder than before. But then I began to realize that it wasn't about spending more time working harder, it was about working smarter. My old study system just wasn't good enough, and I was spending too much time getting mediocre results. So about midway through my first year in medical school, I did a complete overhaul of my study system to diagnose what barriers were preventing me from being more efficient. And I pinpointed it to the idea of flow. When you begin to study, there's a certain amount of friction that you have to overcome before you reach something called the flow state. Maybe you know what I'm talking about. It's about reaching that state of focus where you're wired in on your task. We experience it all the time when we're at the gym or cleaning the house or studying. So playing off this idea, I identified two ways to increase my study efficiency. First was to reduce the friction to reaching the flow state. Make it as easy as possible to build momentum to reach this desired state of mind. And the second was to maintain this level of stimulation. So with those two issues in mind, I searched for a solution. And after experimenting with all kinds of note-taking and programs, I finally arrived at a single streamlined solution, which is RemNote. RemNote solves both the issues I was having with reaching the flow state and maintaining the flow state. And after some more tweaks and fine-tuning, my grades started to climb again. And now, I've been able to get pretty consistent grades while also enjoying more free time because my study system is well-refined. So for the rest of this video, I want to share with you roughly how I use RemNote to study. And then I'll talk about why I think it works so well to solve my study problems. In medicine, all my big learning concepts are broken down into different segments. In RemNote, I did the same by making different folders here on the side for each of my different blocks in school, like cardiology, hematology, so on and so forth. And I gave them all a little flair with emojis because it's fun and aesthetically pleasing. It's a way that removes friction for me because I then enjoy using the program to study, and that's a huge win. So I'm about to start OB. Let me show you inside the folders at what kind of content I'm actually studying. Since I'm in my clinical years now, all of my studies really focus on recognizing symptoms and pathology and understanding the correct treatment protocol. So for the most part, I make little sections for each disease. In RemNote, we call these parent terms, and all the information beneath the parents are children. So for example, my note ectopic pregnancy is the parent, and if I expand it right here, then I can see all the children, which are the risk factors, clinical presentation, diagnosis, treatment, so on and so forth. So that's cool, right? It's super organized. But the real game changer with RemNote is that everything I write automatically becomes a flashcard with spaced repetition, just like Anki. See, I can study this deck here and show you what I mean. My notes from the document transformed into flashcards with spaced repetition features so that the concepts that I know very well will be shown less, and the concepts I don't know well will be shown more often. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, that's totally fine, but definitely check out our playlist here for more of a deep dive into these learning strategies. So before, when I was using normal flashcard apps like Anki or Quizlet, I'd have to spend an entire middle step transferring notes into flashcards. But then the flashcards would just be random tiny bits of information, right? You can't see the big picture from a flashcard. So learning new information and revisiting old information was causing a lot of frustration and friction. It was preventing me from reaching that flow state because I couldn't focus on the actual act of learning. I was too busy making flashcards and also trying to figure out how to organize my studies. Whereas in RemNote, I structure all my notes and they automatically become flashcards, and the flashcards have context of the big picture. And if that wasn't amazing enough in itself, RemNote has so many other clutch features that make your workflow even smoother. I can add notes or make edits to any piece of information in RemNote from any document. I can add pictures, links, backlinks, This is really where problem two is addressed for me. Let me show you real quick. I'm just gonna open up a new document here with today's date. And say I wanted to add something to the ectopic pregnancy parent. I could open up a portal and type in ectopic pregnancy and embed that right here. Then I can add whatever I want, and this note will still remain in my OB folder, as you can tell from the breadcrumbs on top. You can also make clickable references to other notes you've made. Like for treatment, I could link my note to methotrexate, which is the drug of choice here. I can hover over to see what it says, or I can even open it up in a second panel. And that lets me compare multiple ideas at the same time. I want to show you one more thing, my favorite trick to memorizing everything, which is using mnemonics. RemNote has a special flashcard called a list rem that shows you the answers to your flashcard in order, which is perfect for mnemonics. Let me pull up an example. I'll make another portal and bring in gestational hypertension. So the mnemonic, he likes my neonate, helps me remember which blood pressure medicines are safe during pregnancy, which are hydralazine, labetalol, alpha-methyldopa, and nifedipine. So when I study this REM, which I'll do right now, it'll show me the answers one at a time so I can recite the mnemonic out loud and make sure I know it well. Whereas if I just use a regular flashcard, I would get all the answers at once. I love using mnemonics, and RemNote's list function is perfect. So that's kind of what I do. Each day as I'm learning new stuff, I just work in a daily document like this, and I can just add info to all the correct body systems using portals. Not only am I filing new information into the proper places in my mind, I'm also reinforcing old ideas in the process because I can see the big picture. And then when I need to study them, I just do the automatically generated flashcards. So this seamless and intelligent workflow of RemNote removes all the possible friction that could disrupt my flow state, and I can stay productive for a lot longer. Basically, I like to think of what I'm doing as making a giant, personalized Wikipedia of information for myself. I can prioritize understanding the relationships between my studies without having to worry about making flashcards, since it's built into RemNote. My entire study system is a lot more complex, and there are a lot of moving parts, but hopefully that gives you somewhat of an idea to how powerful RemNote is in the process. If you want to see step-by-step how I study, I created an online course with Mike called Method to Mastery. It's completely free to access if you have a Skillshare account, which is really easy to sign up for. And you can get 2 free months if you use our link in the description, or I'll put it in the comments as well, which is way more time than you need to finish the course. So definitely feel free to check out other courses as well. But anyways, thanks so much for watching. I hope you picked up some useful tips from this video. I'd love it if you could like the video and consider subscribing if you're not already. I'll see you guys next time. I hope you enjoyed that video. Give it a thumbs up because it really helps us out. And if you want to see more, click on the red subscribe button down here or the circle up here. Check out our website or check out our Instagram, links in the description below. And check out these videos over here. We think you might enjoy them.
And we'll see you next time.